quick updates about my situation right now. I don't know what I'm going to be doing on the morning of Saturday, November 23rd. The Vancouver Canucks have a 9:30 game, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to watch that. I might be sleeping. But right now, as I'm recording this video, it's 4 p.m. Friday, November 22nd, so I'm actually going on a little bit of a road trip for a little bit over the weekend, so I won't know if I'll actually be able to watch the game. But for now, I'm pre-recording this video right here, and I'm going to upload it at an appropriate time because I won't have the accessibility to making videos as frequently as I can at the moment when I go on my trip. Let's talk a little bit about Petrus Palmu. Yeah, that's the guy we're talking about today. Palmu, the small Finnish NHL draft prospect that the Vancouver Canucks took a year after he was actually draft eligible for the first time. You probably know who Petrus Palmu is, right? Well, if you don't, that's okay too, because let's just go over what exactly the story is with Petrus Palmu and how things are shaping up right now, because right now, Petrus Palmu is an elite Finnish winger playing in the Finnish Liiga. Is that going to translate into NHL eliteness? I don't know, most likely not, but for the time being, Palmu is putting up some really good Liiga numbers and is among one of the best players in that league for JYP Jyväskylä. Petrus Palmu was drafted by the Vancouver Canucks in 2017 in the 6th round, 181st overall. In his draft year, which was 2015-16, he was just under a point per game. It wasn't amazing, but the fact of the matter is he wasn't drafted in his first year of draft eligibility. In his draft plus 2 year, he had 98 points in 62 games with the Owen Sound Attack, which was good enough to get the Vancouver Canucks to take him in the 6th round. Now, that's a great amount of production for a guy who was in his draft plus 2 year. So why did the Vancouver Canucks wait so late to take him? And why was he not drafted in the first place all the way back in 2016? Well, it's because the guy's 5'6". 5'6", 172 pounds, and back when he was 18, he was even smaller than that. So you could imagine that the idea of drafting a guy like Petrus Palmu certainly didn't present itself as a go-to option. We saw Cole Caufield in the most recent draft at 5'7 get passed over time in and time out again and again, even though he was probably the best goal scorer in the draft. In fact, he was the best goal scorer in the draft. Petrus Palmu then went over to the TPS Turku in the Finnish Liiga, had a really nice season over there, won the Rookie of the Year in Finland, but then he came to Utica, and that wasn't amazing. He played 12 games with the Utica Comets last season, only had one assist, and then he yeeted all the way over back to Europe. It wasn't a good situation with Utica. The other guys that were there, Gadjevic, Lind, and Dahlin, they weren't really producing at the rate that people thought that they would with the Comets, and that's the reason the whole Trent Kull coaching idea has been brought up as a discussion point among several Vancouver Canucks-related discussions online, etc. But Petrus Palmu went back to Finland. He did a pretty okay job back with the TPS Turku, 18 points in 29 games last season, but now he's being loaned out to JYP Jyväskylä, and he's got a lot of points. 18, in fact, the same amount of points that he had last season, but in 15 fewer games played. So Petrus Palmu is over a point per game right now with 18 points in 14 JYP Jyväskylä games. Palmu is currently playing on the second line with Miska Sikkonen and Julius Nattinen. I apologize if I really butchered those right now, but Nattinen is actually the player who leads the JYP Jyväskylä in points. He's all the way up there at 31. Petrus Palmu is actually fourth on his team in points, although he played less games than the majority of his team right now. So Petrus Palmu has been a really good addition to this team, and he wasn't there actually for the entire season. He added on a little bit later after the season started, so he's just kind of getting his licks in there right now. He missed about 9 or so games, but these 14 games that he has played, he's got 18 points, he's doing a pretty good job. As a 22-year-old guy who's only 5'6", he's doing a really good job holding his own and being a good scoring force out there in Finland. He's among the elite in that league, and his linemate, Natinen, is actually first in points per game in the Liga. Palmu is second in the entire league in points per game. So, right now, taking a look at how things have lined up, Petrus Palmu has really started establishing himself as a player who probably could take the next step into a higher-tiered league. That was actually the plan, if you recall correctly, because going back to the beginning of the year, the agent Todd Diamond actually spoke out and said the goal was to get Palmu playing in a league that was better than the Liga, so potentially the KHL or the SHL, because the guaranteed idea was that he wouldn't go back to play in Utica just yet, and that he wouldn't go back to playing with TPS because he already spent 2 years over there and he wanted to progress forward. Nowadays, he's playing on the same line as the best player in the Liga in Natinen, and he's doing some pretty good things, putting up some better numbers than he did with TPS, and now we're going to take a look at what Palmu is going to be able to offer going down the line. And down the line, I see it like this, personally. I see Petrus Palmu coming back to Utica. Next year, he's going to be with the Utica Comets, and I think he's going to be much better than one assist in 12 games shows. I would say that Petrus Palmu has taken these kind of ghost-like steps. You don't really see the steps coming out, but if you take a look at how he plays and how confident he's getting out there with the puck, it really translates. Because Petrus Palmu, when he was with Utica a year ago, he wasn't really being used in the best way. He wasn't really being put in the best positions to succeed. And Trent Call's overall coaching philosophy sparked a lot of controversy around the fan base because of the way that guys like Cole Lind, Gadjevich, and Palmu were being used out there on the ice. Cole Lind is a guy who's actually exploded offensively, and he's doing much better now than he was last year. Jonathan Dahlin actually is back in Sweden, and he kind of took a little bit of a step back, but he's doing really well in Sweden in the Allsvenskan nevertheless, so I don't know what's going to go on with him and his NHL future. And Jonah Gadjevich is a guy who was Palmu's line mate in junior. He's a different kind of player, so I think the profiling and the ideas that we're presenting here don't really apply to him because he's more of a hitting, physical kind of guy. But Petrus Palmu, if you put him in a position to succeed, you play him with good players, I think he's got a really good chance to do some damage in the AHL next year. And maybe that even comes sooner than next year. Maybe his JYP Jyväskylä season ends a little bit early. They don't make the playoffs or whatever. It's unlikely because they have a lot of players that are over a point a game. But he comes back over to Utica at the end of the year, does a really good job, and maybe goes the Lukas Jašek route where he does really well after being a late addition to that squad. But Petrus Palmu, to me, is a guy that has some slim NHL potential, but is somebody that I don't want to rule out entirely. Sure, he's only 5'6", but the guy's a fire hydrant. He's fit. And for a guy who's only 5'6", the weight is honestly quite a lot. 172 pounds is not light for a guy who's only 5'6", and in fact, this is kind of the meme. People talk about his tree trunks that he has for legs, because the guy's got some really thick thighs that allow him to really use his center of gravity to protect the puck and actually be competitive in a pro hockey environment, where the guys are usually 6 feet and up, where the guys are 200 pounds and up, and Petrus Palmu is only 5'6". It's served him well in the past, it's serving him well right now, and going forward into the future, I don't think it should be an obstacle that will hold him back from making the NHL one day. Do I see him as an elite talent in the NHL? No. Right now, he's elite in the Liga, but that's not guaranteed to translate into the NHL. He's not going to be a point-per-game player with the Canucks down the line. But I wouldn't be surprised if Petrus Palmu was maybe a middle six guy. Maybe a guy that you place in your bottom six that comes out during the PK or can be used on a second power play unit. Petrus Palmu has a unique skill set that's fueled by some good offensive IQ and a really good frame for a guy who's only 5'6". A guy who can actually power his way through even though he's really small, and a guy who actually does know how to succeed given the circumstances that he's given with his small frame. Which is why he's a unique player. And I think it's really interesting to note that he has been succeeding, and he has been taking these steps forward, and as a guy who's 22 being over a point per game in the Finnish Liga, I think that's a pretty good resume. Sure, he's not going to become elite in the NHL, but I think he could become something. And I've been saying that for a while. So we'll see if that actually does transpire, but for now, I hope you enjoyed this video. Social Edge from Host 99, and bye.